What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and in this video, I want to talk about if Harry Potter is basically waiting on next gen in order for it to be announced. So, I'm recording this on Wednesday. Let's see how well I can do in predicting things up until Saturday in terms of we don't know what the heck could happen over the next 2.5 days, you know, into Saturday. Lots happened already in the beginning of this week. But really quickly, before I jump into it, I do want to promote my Twitter. If you guys are not already following me on Twitter, PodcastNow15 is my Twitter username. The link for it will also be in the description below. Just another way of getting in contact with me, another way of reaching me, another way for me to engage with you guys, and we have a lot of fun over there as well. All right, so at the time I'm recording this, Series X, Series S, good to go, pre-order date, price, release date. PlayStation, again, as of Wednesday, middle of the day, has yet to go. Could they go over the next 2 days? They could. And if they do, and if it already has happened, I think I'll leave this video up because I think it doesn't really change all that much. What I'm specifically talking about in this video is, well, that's definitely one of the things. The price, pre-orders, release date, those are all very important things that I do think Harry Potter could be waiting on. But another thing is, look, as we get closer to these consoles coming out, I really do think, and as we continue to go through the months, by the way, of no Harry Potter, look, because it was supposed to be at E3, and I say this every time, but I think it's important to always say, because it was supposed to be at E3, now it's not. We've gotten through DC Fandom, okay, all that's done, all that's fantastic, and we're looking for a time where this game could be announced. Now, again, could it be announced on its own? Yes. The more I talk about it, though, the more I really, and I maybe convince myself, and this is something that we probably shouldn't do, but I will make an exception, and I'll also make it very clear that, look, I've talked myself up in terms of like my own theories before. I'm sure I've given other people hope, and if you are mad at me for that, I'm truly, truly sorry, but that's just something to, you know, keep in mind, okay? I'm not always right. You have to take even what I'm saying with a grain of salt. I know I sometimes get myself very, very excited about things when I probably shouldn't, but with that being said, a huge, huge but, I do think I'm coming around more to the idea that I've even been saying for months of, could they package this in with a PS5 event of some sorts? Now, that's why I really don't think this video is going to get all that old, because no matter what, if the systems, you know, if PlayStation goes and they do the same thing as Microsoft did, well, okay, you got that out of the way, but look, the consoles come out in 2 months. Literally, I mean, less than 2 months at this point that you guys are watching this, does Series X for sure come out, and then maybe PlayStation, you know, maybe another 2 months and like a couple of days from now, but they're going to come. And what I'm trying to, you know, wrap around is they need to have another event. They need to have an event similar to the Xbox Game Showcase that they've had, you know, in July. They need to have an event similar to the PlayStation 5 reveal event that they had in early June. Both companies, I really do believe, need another one. Now, you know, to not attack Microsoft, is there all that much they could show at theirs? Not really. Honestly, I think you only have a handful of your exclusives that you can do. Yes, you could have third-party deals, and I do think it's necessary, by the way, again, that they do something, and I really do think they will. And also PlayStation. PlayStation has their own exclusives, and what we've heard so often, and by the way, this is not going to be a PlayStation exclusive. Harry Potter is not going to be a PlayStation exclusive, but we've heard so much about how they have deals on the table with all of these different companies, these third-party deals that they're holding off on announcing because they want to one-up Microsoft. I think Harry Potter could be part of that. I don't know. Okay, I'm not an insider. I don't know these things. I don't think that it requires to be exclusive to, by the way, have this partnership. It could be some sort of exclusive. I mainly mean like literally only being on PlayStation. There's no way that happens. We've seen it happen before where some things maybe arrive first on PlayStation, like by a week, or maybe they have like a DLC thing, or maybe it's like a skin, or it's, you know, something. And you also have to remember that these companies have partnerships. Now, really, Warner Bros. Has been back and forth. Like, sometimes they'll have partnerships with Microsoft, sometimes they'll have partnerships with Sony. Remember, they announced Arkham Knight. Now, that's obviously a different Warner Bros. Game, but they announced Arkham Knight fully, like the reveal, you know, trailer for it, at that E3. That E3, I believe 2014 is when they showed that off. So, like, there's been examples before. I really do think that's it. And for Harry Potter, and we have to talk about this in terms of what consoles does it release on. Well, for the longest time, I had said that I think this game, and actually, this is going to probably be something that's aged really well, because I've been saying this probably for like a year or longer. And I've said that I think this game probably could be on both current and next gen, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's the first wave of games that are only on next gen. Now, what we're seeing with a lot of games is 2021, the first half, these games are coming out on all consoles. So Far Cry, which is a Ubisoft one. You have Gotham Knights, which is a Warner Bros. One, right? Good to note. And I'm sure we can, Hitman. Hitman is actually their own, right? IO Interactive. It's their own thing. So you have a couple examples right there of all these different companies, and they're going to be on all consoles. But you look into the future. Look at another Warner Bros. Game, Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League, 2022. That game is only on next gen. Now, you would expect 2022 to only be, I think it's not unfair at all. You know, I've always kind of been on people's sides where it's like, you know, the people that say, well, I don't have enough money to get next gen consoles. I hope it's on current gen. I'm with you, but I'm only with you until the end of 2021, to be quite honest with you, because once we get into 2022, a full year after next gen, we got to start focusing. You know what I mean? I think that's just how the business works, is you have to focus on the new thing. You can't keep supporting the old stuff when you're trying to go into brand new territory. You know what I mean? So I'm with you on you not having enough money or, you know, whatever situation it is up until the end of next year, and then we got to move on. The problem with Harry Potter is that I still think it could be fall 2021, but there's two things. Well, one, if I'm wrong, which obviously has happened before, if I'm wrong and this game is like 2022, early 2022, and then say Suicide Squad is late 2022, it's going to be next gen only. I really don't think there's any way around it. Or if I am still right and it is fall of 2021, it could still be the first wave of games that are only on next gen. And I think we're going to see that. Yes, there'll be some that do not advance. Call of Duty next year, probably Battlefield, next year's Battlefield. Those games will still be on current gen. All the sports games, they'll be on both current and next gen. And I'm talking about fall of 2021 here, okay? But I think a lot of other games by the fall are going to start making that jump. Microsoft can say all they want that they want the games on both consoles, but you are going to have games leaving. Just factually, you're going to. Now, the exclusives are different. Sony's exclusives are just going to be on PS5 for the most part. Microsoft exclusives are going to be on everything except for the weird coincidences when they're not, which again goes against Microsoft's whole strategy. It's why I don't necessarily like that they say these things, because they basically are lying to us consistently. So for Harry Potter, this is a good example. You know, again, you look at Call of Duty, Battlefield, sports games, and whatever other games come out in the fall, okay? I'm sure there's going to be a lot of games. Those games are probably going to be both. But you look at a big game like this Harry Potter Warner Bros. Game, it could very, very well only be on next gen. And so why did I spend 3-4 minutes talking about that? Well, if it's next gen, then you have to kind of wait for this next gen stuff. Look, at this point, we don't really have all that much next-gen games. We do. In the grand scheme of things, we actually have a lot. But how have we gotten them? Well, some of them have gone on their own, but not really. Most of them have all come during these events, during these PlayStation-held or Xbox-held events. That's where we get these games. You're not seeing many games that are announced that are coming out February, March, April, May, June. How many games do we know in that time period that are coming out? Next to none. Now, are they waiting specifically on next-gen? No, gaming also works different where they're not going, you don't always announce your game super far out. Also, with the stuff that went around the world, I'm sure a lot of things got pushed. So, I mean, I understand there's obviously different aspects to it as well. But a big reason is I feel like you have to wait until at least the full-on specs, the full-on release date, November, December, January. I think we're going to get a lot of information about a lot of games coming in 2021 or even later. That's when I think we're going to get it. We've already started to see it over the summer months. We've seen a lot of gaming developers say, oh, I like the haptic feedback that the controller, the DualSense controller gives, or I like this spec or this thing that Series X can do, or I like this thing that the PS5 can do. We're starting to see it, but it's very kind of mum and it's not a lot. I do think after, that's when we get a lot. Now, you could say that actually helps the argument of, well, maybe Game Awards. Because Game Awards could be enormous because Jeff Keighley can go to all these developers and say, hey, you've been waiting for next gen to maybe release, maybe get formally announced, whatever, or have all the info come out. and it's happened now. Now are you ready to talk about or show your game? You want to do it at the Game Awards. And I think that's a really, really good time to do it. So you could argue that. I would also argue, again, if Sony or if Microsoft has some sort of connection with Warner Bros. Where they've agreed, hey, we'll be the ones to show off. And again, it doesn't even have to be. I know I spent time talking about the exclusivity thing. It could be. Something could be exclusive. Some part of it could be exclusive. Or it could just be literally like a gentleman's agreement where they're like, hey, yeah, we'll show your game. Like, we'll be the platform that gets your game, the announcement. Like, it's going to do fantastic. Either one could do that. And we're not done. You know, we still have the end of September. We still have October. And I really do think at some point in one of the next, you know, in over the next month and a half, we're going to get another event for both. I really do think. I think it's going to be probably the biggest event for either that we've seen so far. And I guess maybe in general, right? Because then the consoles would come out. And that's going to just be, you know, everything, anything they have left to talk about, anything they were waiting on to compete with the other one, this is when they'll do it. And if Harry Potter is part of that, you know, again, you look at what they did with the PS5 reveal event, you look at what they did with some of the Xbox stuff, like they just, sometimes they throw stuff in there. And if Warner Bros. Goes and they say, yeah, you know, we were looking at E3, we couldn't do it, obviously, because it was canceled. We have our other games announced. We need something to push Harry Potter. We could do it on our own, but you know what? PlayStation approached us and said, hey, do you want to do it on one of our shows or, you know, one of like our events? And we said, you know what I mean? That could very, very well happen. So again, I know I'm talking kind of myself into it, and that's probably a bad thing. I'm not guaranteeing it. I am very confident in saying that I think this game is going to be announced by the end of the year. I know I've always said September, October. I still think it's very, very possible it gets announced in September, October. And if not, then we wait another month and a half, not even, right, early December, and then the Game Awards. So again, we are pretty much at the end of this tunnel. We truly, truly are. I do think that there's just one kind of barrier, waiting. And to be quite honest with you, again, that does, the fact that I really do feel like kind of are waiting on next gen, to me, does push the idea that it could only be on next gen. And think about it. If the leak was 2018, October 2018, and maybe they were working on it for like a year, it does make sense that they could have been working on it largely for next gen. If you start a game, if you started a game in 2017, 2018, it's pretty likely, not fully, but it's pretty likely that that game could be only next gen. It really could. And if the game takes, you know, 3, 4, 5 years, again, depending on when they started it, then it kind of all lines up if you think about it like that. So guys, let me know in the comments below, what do you think? Do you think it's waiting on PS5, waiting on Series X? Do you think it'll appear at a PlayStation event? If a event does get announced for either of these, you know, consoles or companies, I'll definitely make a follow-up video, you know, talking more specifically about that. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. As always, make sure you guys are subscribed, bell icon. You guys have been the absolute best. I love making these videos. I love making them once a week, and I can't wait to make more of them once we actually see what the game looks like, you know, officially and fully. So again, make sure you guys did all that. Following me on Twitter, PodcastNow15, and I will see you guys on next week's Harry Potter video.